Former President Rodrigo Duterte vows support for his successor, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., but he also says he and his dominant political party, PDP Laban, will keep a close eye on the new government and will serve as fiscalizers if needed. Duterte gave that statement as he presided over PDP Laban's National Assembly on Thursday.
I would like to make this thing very, very clear. We are not putting up a strong party against the party of the president. We are not going to quarrel with him. Far from it, we will be giving our full support for him politically. We feel that we have this more than duty to serve the country. Sana, I hope that I would like to wish the president good luck, and I hope he would govern this country in accordance to what is demanded of the people's interest. But the president can be very sure that in the coming days, we will fiscalize. Pag may nakita tayong masama, we will raise our voice because that is the essence of our presence here.
PDP Laban also elected new leaders. Duterte was given a fresh term as chairman, while Palawan 2nd District Representative Jose Pepito Alvarez is the new president, replacing Alfonso Cusi. Senator Robin Padillo is the new executive vice president. The leadership change comes amid a continuing challenge by Senator Coco Pimentel to the legitimacy of the party faction led by Cusi. Pimentel had appealed the decision of the Election Commission, which recognized Cusi's win as the true and official members of the PDP Laban. The party split into two factions before the May 2022 elections, with the Cusi faction supporting the presidential ticket of Marcos and Sara Duterte.
On Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. eyes better cooperation with institutions like the Asian Development Bank to build a better normal for Filipinos. The president spoke at an event organized by the ADB where he stressed his government's commitment to make the country more resilient and sensitive to people's needs. Since his working trip to New York, Marcos has been presenting the Philippines as an attractive investment destination, which he says is ready for partnerships.
While many things remain uncertain, one thing is for sure. We can no longer return to the way things were. It is time for us to work together to bring about an even better normal. I believe that at the heart of this goal is in the way that we must develop an economy that is green, that is sustainable, truly climate resilient, and responsive to people's immediate needs. It is an economy that takes into account the ecosystem from which we harness our resources. As president, it is certainly my duty to ensure that the government remains committed in the efficient and effective utilization of this institution's assistance for the full benefit of all Filipinos.
Malacanang says business commitments secured from the U.S. working visit of Philippine President Marcos Jr. have an estimated value of $3.9 billion. The Presidential Palace says these investment pledges can potentially create some 102,000 jobs, 112 rather. The pledges cover the information technology and business process management sector, as well as manufacturing.